school is it? I'll hold it.
Good afternoon. I'm First Deputy Mayor Sheena Wright, and we are joined here by members of the NYPD, New York City Public Schools, and the MTA, and other leaders in the administration. We have been in constant communication with Mayor Adams. We are here to discuss three significant events that happened today involving young people. Mayor Adams and our administration are laser focused on keeping our children safe, and so we're going to go through those items and answer any questions. First up is First Deputy Commissioner.
We're here today because the city saw several tragic and concerning incidents with juveniles. One of the incidents involved a homicide on the juvenile aboard an empty bus. As a mother of two children in school, I am deeply disturbed by today's events. However, we will show you how our city agencies, along with our fellow New Yorkers, came together in a time of crisis and responded in unison to show the strength of our city. I will now pass it over to Chief of Patrol, John Shell.
Good evening, everyone. So I'm going to talk about three incidents that occurred today in a 2.5 hour span from roughly 12 noon to 2:30, involving crimes and incidents in and around our school system. The first incident I'll touch on will be at 12 o'clock today, 70 Precinct, East 16th and Avenue M. We have a 16-year-old female student walking from Morrow High School about a block away. She's going towards the bus stop. We believe at this time there were two groups of kids that were opposite of each other. I believe gunshots rang out. She was not the intended target, and she was shot and grazed in the ankle. As this occurs, she continues to a transit system, grabs two police officers in addition to numerous 911 calls, and she is rendered aid and removed to a local hospital. In regards to the story, the incident, we believe it's a gang motivated incident. We believe one group points a gun at another group. The other group has a gun and fires and hits the 16-year-old. Incident number two, about 1:15 this afternoon, 850 10th Avenue, Midtown North Precinct, the Independence High School and Environmental Studies High School. We believe a family associate reports to the school that a 15-year-old brought a gun to school. At this point, our communication system with the public school system and school safety division, NYPD. The school immediately puts the school in a hard lockdown and a search for the gun commences. This search entailed canine, a heavy response from the police department and school safety division, and we start looking for this firearm. A decision is made on the scene to evacuate the school and do a reverse scanning to find this firearm. When they do the reverse scanning, they ultimately find a firearm we're looking for. Then they find a second firearm on a different student, and they find an imitation pistol on a third student. As we sit here tonight, the school is still being searched with numerous pieces of resources and canine to see if there are any other firearms in the school. I would like to just enhance the communication and the speed and accuracy which we responded with school safety, with the principals, with a civilian who we ask always for their help, who sounded the alarm on this situation, who came up to school and went to school safety offices and reported this. And the result is nobody hurt today, two firearms removed from school and an imitation gun. That speaks to our school plan that came about last year and continues to get better, and it's all about communication and speed, and that's what you saw here today. The third incident, 122 Precinct, Staten Island, about 2:30 today, Highland Boulevard and Littlefield Avenue, on an MTA bus. We have at least two males in a confrontation, two students, two youths, 13 and 14-year-old, maybe more. Witnesses state there's an argument on a bus. A knife is produced, and gang signs were being shown back and forth. We have a male stabbed in the chest. Our perpetrator flees this bus, runs approximately three blocks. At this time, we have a good Samaritan Again, someone getting involved, like we ask. We have a retired sergeant for NYPD, and we have a New York State Department of Environmental Conservative officer on the scene. So we have three independent people who are helping. The retired sergeant starts to follow the male who did the stabbing. At this time, another witness points him out and says, this person just stabbed somebody. And the sergeant effects the arrest. Again, tragic homicide today. We believe this motive possibly is gang-related again. The quick response by the NYPD and the great response from our community, the Good Samaritan, the retired sergeant, and the on-duty officer from the DEC. Again, the motive looks like gang, and unfortunately, the child passed away. Right now, we'll take any questions. Chancellor,
Anthony DiLorenzo, Pix 11.
First question is for NYPD, second is for Commissioner Banks. With the guns that were found, the tip that came in from the parent, what was the concern aside from them bringing a gun to school? Was there any threat of violence at the school?
Well, obviously the associate of the child was concerned that a firearm was coming to a school with young kids, and that's a recipe for disaster. And by that person doing so, and the speed that we reacted to this with School Safety Division, DOE, the police department, the principals, John Jay College, who opened their doors to responding parents, collectively, we prevented a tragedy today, possibly.
All right, we're going to go over to Ace Zakin from Fox 5.
Okay, at the beginning of this year, Mayor Adams and Chancellor Banks, along with the NYPD, put a new safety plan into effect for our NYC public schools. Is it safe to say that tonight there are two less guns on the street because of this plan?
Absolutely. This plan, if you recall last year in the late winter, early spring, we had some school shootings. On behalf of the mayor, our police commissioner, our chief of department, DOE, the chancellor, we put this plan together, and you saw it working today. So the answer to your question is yes.
I would add to that. It's important to recognize that the mayor put in place a very, very stringent communications plan that we developed last year, where we now have on a weekly basis. The commanding officers of every precinct in New York City are in communication with the principals of the schools in that command district. And that level of communication, I think, has been very, very helpful to our schools and keeping our kids safe all across New York City. We are deeply, deeply troubled. I'm personally troubled as the chancellor anytime we have a loss of life in such a tragic and needless way. But I will say that the communication level and the plan that we do have in place that was instituted by our mayor is working across New York City. We know we still have a lot of work to do, but we feel good about the communications, as the chief pointed out, and the level of speed and accuracy by which we're able to respond.
All right, we're going to go over to Mac Rosenberg from 1010 Wins.
For Commissioner Banks, do you worry that teens in schools could be operating their gangs? You have at least two incidents that police say involve gang activity with teenagers that are in public schools. Do you have concern about that?
I'm certainly concerned. You know, when you see issues and incidents like this, it is deeply concerning. It is concerning when you find out that there are firearms in the schools, even though they've not been used, thank God. So we still have to continue a deeper level of communication. We've got to let all of our kids know that if they see something, they have to say something to keep themselves safe as well. But yes, absolutely, I'm very concerned. I'm always concerned when we have issues of safety, and particularly issues of weapons and weapons being brought into our schools. We've not seen a significant uptick in incidents in our schools. I want to emphasize that. Inside of our schools, have been safe. The issues we have found have continued to be issues outside of the school, and that's why we need to continue to have this enhanced level of communication with NYPD, our school safety agents, our school leaders, and our community members as well. It's a big part of the reason why we develop programs like Project Pivot, where we want our community also paying attention and letting us know what they are also seeing. No one of these entities can solve it by themselves. We will only solve these issues by all of us working together.
Any other questions? Spot 5,
does the MTA have anything to say about this?
It's absolutely tragic. I responded to the scene, spoke with the bus operator, and he's visibly broken up about what transpired, but was able to maintain his calm, notified the communications, contacted the police rapidly, and did a fantastic job in trying to maintain calm on the bus. Being a father of two teens myself and a preteen, it's just a very tragic incident, and our thoughts and prayers are with the families on both sides. So.
All right. Any other questions? Anthony, you know, that's the last question.
So the school where the two guns were found, we're told there was no scanning in the morning. After the tip came in, they brought in the scanners to find the guns. What's the DOE's position on adding more scanners? Are there a sufficient amount of scanners in all the schools, or is this something you're looking to expand with school safety?
It's a good question, and it's something that we're always on a regular basis constantly taking a look at whatever safety precautions that we do need to put in place. We don't have scanning across our 1,600 buildings across New York City, and in many of these cases, it's not even warranted. But we analyze this on an ongoing basis, and when we find that we have incidents that we need to address in a different kind of way. We have random scanning that happens around the city as well. Schools that don't have scanning on a daily basis. So there are a number of things that we're doing. We'll take a look here as well, but it is very concerning for me, absolutely. We're going to take a look at all things, at expanding, how do we increase more random scanning that happens across our schools as well. So all of it is on the table for us to take a look at.
But I just want to add, when we talk about expanding, I just want to be clear about your questions. When we do an evaluation of the schools, there are some schools that's on that we look to determine whether or not they no longer need to be on. Kids going to school every day that have to go through school like they're going through an airport, it's not a healthy environment. So what we're looking at, I want to be clear, when you say about expanding, the assessment is always being done. Do some schools, do they need to stay on scanning? Do we need to remove them on scanning? Other ones, do we need to put them on scanning? And other ones, how do we need to be able to keep moving around our random scanning day to day? We don't want an environment that people have to come to school, kids have to come to school and go through the scanning, but we certainly, more importantly, don't want an environment where people are at school not being safe. So I just want to be clear about the expanding aspect of your good question.
All right, well, last question back here.
Were there any arrests made?
So yes, in the 70 precinct shooting I mentioned, that was the first event, responding units from the public safety team from the 70 precinct did apprehend an individual with a firearm that at this point we believe was used in that shooting, and the Detective Bureau is working through that right now.
Thank you, everybody. All right, thank you, everyone. Thank you for your time and attention. Thank you.